styling it like this, how it's a little brush. So the first thing you need to know if you're doing a cat eye is there's three points: the inner corner point, the wing point, and the point that reaches your outer corner. So what you want to do is, for my eye, how you see how I have all these creases here, the main thing about that is people usually, because my eyebrow also is shorter than most people's, your eyebrow goes to probably about here. That's where you want your wing liners, like the outer wing, to be, like just going from your, going from this corner to the point of your, like the tail of your eyebrow. I have shitty eyebrows, so I'm just gonna put a dot there. You see that? Okay. So what you wanna do from that point is you wanna drag your eyeliner inward to about here. You see how when I'm facing here, it'll be like the line of where the, not the pupil, the iris of my eye is. So I take it. See that? And then you wanna grab it from here and drag it down here. So it's not perfect, obviously, but what the main point of this is, you get the shape like that, and then you fill it in like here. The fastest way to fill it in is to flat pat your eyeliner around like that and just drag it over. And then, if you want to get the point like I just did, you go from the inner corner and sweep it out and you flick your brush a little bit. See that? How it created that point? See that? So, obviously, let that dry. The only thing about liquid liner that I hate is, like what you said before, how it takes forever to freaking dry. I think we're good. So that's basically it for just the wing. But if you want to go like full on, like crazy in some cat eye, you want to do the inner corner point, which is where it, you follow from your tear duct and you go out and then back. So let me kind of demonstrate it. I'm very bad at this still. See how that line, like, when my eye is like this, it's straight, so that's what causes the cat eye. When you look forward, it just looks kind of stupid, so you need to connect that over. I naturally have a line going here, so I can connect that to that bottom line, but you connect it to however thick you want your bottom liner to be. As you can see, it's not slanted enough, so I will draw it down more. See how now it's a bit more onto switch into gel just because this liner is drying out a little bit. But let me quickly try to fill in a bit more. Just to get that cleaner line, because liquid is definitely a cleaner line. But I have to switch to gel for now. Where is my gel liner brush? Here it is. Nope, that is not it. It's definitely more forgiving than liquid liners. And okay, so now you just want to fill in the underneath of your eye, and you want these lines to be as crisp as you possibly can get. I'm just going in very lightly, so it's not going to be very dark or crisp at all. But it'll get there. The good thing about gel liner is you can actually fill in your waterline with it too. And now, as you can tell, it's getting messy, so I need to sharpen it up. And now from this corner, I'm gonna thicken up the wing like so. See how that's still really messy? That is okay. Alright. That's basically it. What I usually do is I'm not going to waste a baby wipe now because I'm not going out. But what I tend to do is I take a baby wipe and I just wipe it like that. And it sharpens the line out completely. And that's how you do a cat eye. It takes a long ass time to get perfect. And sad because I think my liquid liner just ran out, so that's why I really goofed today, but the point got across. These are going to be unedited, I'm sorry Sammy, I love you, but I can't be bothered to edit them right now, and yeah, so you just gotta make sure these lines are right. And actually, the best thing you can do, if you really want this to look instead of making the bottom line perfect, take black eyeshadow, which I just did, and blur it out like so. Yes, sir.